This game is a work of fiction. Any resemblance to actual people or organizations is entirely coincidental. Also, be advised that this game includes some graphic imagery. Prologue: Lurking in the Deep. Miu Hinasaki. Spirited away. In the vicinity of Mount Hikami, people have been mysteriously disappearing without a trace. One such girl is Miu Hinasaki. She awakens to find herself in an old, half-flooded building. It's cold.
Where am I?
Who suis-je? What is this place? What am I doing here? No, this is not true. I'm not really seeing them. They're ghosts. They're not here. It's my brain tricking on me. Not this way. I've got to get out of here. Hurry up. I have to get out of here. I have to find a way out of here. Laisse-moi sortir de là, laisse-moi sortir de là, laisse-moi sortir de là. Oh, they're coming. They're coming to get me. I hear them. What am I supposed to do? I don't know where I am. There's light at the end of the corridor. Maybe there's a way out that way. Gotta find the exit. Gotta find the door. But where is the door?
Thank you.
they're chasing after me. I have to get out. Run! I have to run. I have to get out of here. Quick! What is this place? I'm sure there's something coming out from that box. What are you waiting for? Looking and staring at that box. Oh, creepy. Whoa, giving me the creeps so much. Oh yeah, that reminds me of the movie The Ring. Ah, that Japanese horror movie. Oh, I'm gonna die. Please help me. I don't want to be trapped in here with this. I don't know what are those hairs coming out of the box. You want to possess me? You want to possess me. That's what you want, you evil witch. Get out of here! I want to get out of here! Please, 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 please! Miu Hinasaki has disappeared. No one could hear her cries for help. She was sealed into a shrine on top of a mountain. That mountain is where the events of this story take place. We follow the fates of three people, Yuri, Ren, and Miu. It is a terrifying tale of the supernatural. First drop, the vanishing trace. Yuri Kozukata. Shadow reading. Among the residents of the villages at the foot of Mount Hikami, a certain unique ability has been passed through the ages. This ability, known as shadow reading, enables the user to view the shadow or trace of someone lost in inexplicable circumstances. This is not unlike the psychometry practiced elsewhere. Yuri Kozukata accompanies Hisoka Kurosawa, a woman who possesses the shadow reading ability, to an abandoned inn on Mount Hikami. Sensing Yuri could in time become talented at shadow reading, Hisoka takes her along on an assignment.
I thought that I'd be scared of death. but I can't even cry. I am alone. In the end, I am alone. I will end it all. Alone.
Yuri?
Huh?
What we're looking for should be in here. This is an excellent chance for you to take the lead. Here, take this.
Ah.
This is a camera obscura. It will let you see the unseen, including the clues that will help you find what we're here for. This is your opportunity, your first case. I'm sure you'll do well. Let's start with a little practice. It works exactly like a normal camera. Give it a try. Just hold up the camera. What's wrong? It's just like a normal camera. Just look through the viewfinder and press the shutter button. The camera obscura photographs the netherworld, a whole other world separate from our own. That world that we see through the lens is not unlike the afterlife. Make sure not to draw too much interest from the things you see. If you aren't careful, you might be drawn into the netherworld yourself. Around here seem to have changed. It wasn't exactly bustling, but it never used to be like this. Take this. It's a token. It will help lead you to what we're looking for. Now don't panic, but be sure to stay on your guard. Go on, and head inside.
Okay, let's talk about ghosts. Ghosts are spirits of dead people. Most people who believe in spirits think they are not physical, but yet are able to do things that people can do, like see, hear, move around, and make sounds. One favorite kind of ghost story has ghosts haunting houses, graveyards, or old buildings. Some people say they can feel the presence of ghosts, but it is hard to tell whether such people just feel weird because they expect a ghost to be there. Others say they feel it getting colder in spots where ghosts hang out. Many say they hear strange creaking noises or other sounds they think are signs of ghosts. These people are not imagining things. Most hauntings happen in old buildings, like this one, for example, and this king of Project Zero, which tend to be drafty. Scientists who have gone to haunted places to study them say that the temperature changes and the sounds are probably caused by such things as empty spaces behind walls or wind currents set in motion by low frequency sound waves. Ooh, this sounds creepy. Why do ghosts show up only at night or in dark places? Why should ghosts care whether it is day or night? They don't have to work or go to bed early, so they'll be fresh for school the next day. Maybe it's easier for people to find the source of a weird sound or sight in broad daylight. People see more ghosts at night because people can't see what might really be going on. It's usually cooler and breezier at night. Many things make creaking noises as they cool down. The breezes can make scary sounds and move things. The imagination is more likely to run wild in the dark than in the sunlight. Things always seem more mysterious at night. Many people are afraid of the dark because they can see what's really going on around them. Fear is fuel for the imagination. Some people try to talk to ghosts by getting together around a table in a dark room. Seances were popular for a long time, but today many people who say they are mediums don't use any props and they work on a stage. They don't have their ghosts ring bells or float things across the room. This was done in many seances. Today's mediums just say things. Well, let's not talk about mediums. Let's talk about photographs of ghosts. Many people have photographs that look like ghosts are in them. Some of these ghosts are reflections of light off the camera lens. Some are not. Do you believe in those pictures with ghosts in them? When you take a picture using film that has already been used to take a picture, you get both pictures combined into one. If you know how to develop photographs, you can print one picture on top of another and make the two pictures look like one. Well, if you think you've seen a ghost, you are not alone. Many people think they've seen ghosts. Seeing a ghost can be quite scary. I've never seen one. Fortunately, I don't know if they really exist. Not ghost in plural. Most likely what happens when a person sees a ghost is that the brain takes whatever fuzzy information it gets from the eyes, ears, and other senses and thinks there is some sort of being out there that is intentionally moving the way it is or making the sounds it is making. We call beings that can direct their own movements intentional agents. Ooh, it is common for humans to think that objects that are not agents, such as branches of trees moving in the wind, are intentional agents when they are not. Once you know that what you saw and heard was the wind blowing some branches, you stop thinking of ghosts. But if you never get a chance to see clearly what it was that your brain turned into a ghost, you can't be sure that what you saw wasn't a ghost. What you saw, though, was probably created by your imagination. And me, myself, my gosh, my imagination always tricks always strikes me. You might say that when you are scared by seeing a ghost, you are scaring yourself. Why? Because your brain is probably fooling you. Yeah, my brain is fooling me every time. Like, for example, when I play zombies. That's so scary. Oh, yeah. My brain is fooling me. And I'm not seeing a real ghost out there in real space. Anyway, that is what the science tells us. How about you? Out there, if you have some ghost stories, I'll be very, very interested to hear one or to read one or some of your ghost stories. So that's pretty much it. The video ends here. So I'll say see ya. Thanks for watching. Heido. Dai chen. Tschüss. Arrivederci. Sayonara. Au revoir.
Come on, this way. Come on, this way.
So that's pretty much it. The video ends here. So I'll say see ya. Thanks for watching. Heido. Daichen. Tschüss.